Good morning, Boomer Esiason. How are you?
Good morning, guys. Doing well. A lot better than you guys up there. I'll tell you that after watching that game yesterday. What a fiasco. I mean, that's how I would describe the game between the Seahawks and the Patriots. That was a 100% fiasco.
I can only imagine what a pleasant six-hour flight that was home from Seattle last night for those guys.
I'd like to sit next to
them. A lot of guys asking a lot of questions about the way that game was managed. I think there are a lot of players that are looking at themselves saying, what in the hell are we doing out there, especially Ebner and Wilson on the last touchdown pass. Kyle Arrington gets benched. I mean, you know, you literally are playing an offensive game in which you ran up 475 yards on supposedly the number one defense in football. You were only sacked once, and Tom Brady inexplicably threw 58 passes. You think he's on the injured list every week because of a sore shoulder? Well, he'll be out there again this week on the injured list because, I mean, it was just I don't know how you explain a game like that and how you lose a game like that late, giving up 14 points in the fourth quarter.
You know, Boomer, watching this Patriots secondary get lit up really isn't shocking. We've seen a few years of this ineptitude. What is shocking, you mentioned it, is this team's inability to finish off close ball games at the end, not to mention some really bad decisions and playmaking by Tom Brady. That's what was shocking to me.
Well, you know, there's no question that when you're asked to make 58 decisions in a game, somewhere along the line you're going to make some mistakes. And I'll tell you this, what really took my breath away as a player or as a former player that has watched this Patriot team be so buttoned up and make all what I would consider most of the right time making the right decisions from the sideline from Tom's position was the way they ended the first half.
Yeah.
To me that's inexcusable. I mean, 6 seconds to go on the clock. Now you're getting greedy. You're trying to do something that's nearly impossible to do. You know, you should just line up, kick the extra, the field goal right there, and call it a day. And not only did they, I saw teams yesterday all over the NFL making mistakes like this yesterday. I don't know if it was a full moon or what it was, but if you ask me, the end of the first half, while there are so many other things that happened in the fourth quarter that you could point to, that decision and that lack of execution, it was so unpatriot-like and so frustrating, I'm sure, for everybody on that plane coming back and for all the fans out there that I don't know how you can explain that one away.
You know, it is the execution was unpatriot-like, Boomer. I will give you that. But the decision is patriot-like. I think they have, I don't know if you, they're cocky. They're arrogant in some people's minds. And they say, we got 6 seconds. We'll run a play that takes five. Maybe we'll score. Maybe we won't. We'll kick the field goal. Do you think the rest of the league views the Patriots as arrogant? God knows a couple of DBs in Seattle think the Patriots are a little arrogant.
Yeah, I saw the tweet from one of those Seahawks defensive backs. Arrogant? Yeah, I mean, confident is also a word that you can use, I guess, but in this case, I would think there are a few other words that I'd like to use to describe that decision at the end of the first half. That's not, I don't know who makes it. I'm assuming that Bill Belichick makes that decision. I can't believe that, Tom Brady would make that on his own. That's got to be coming from the head coach. Yeah, we can run a play. We can do this. And listen, as for as good as they've been for so long, to sit here on a Monday morning and play Monday morning quarterback, I think you have to get the true answers as to why they did what they did at the end of the first half. To me, that's the most important question. I guess guys can get beat. Young defensive backs are going to get beat. There's no pass rush. You have a young kid in Russell Wilson who's got a cannon for an arm. So I get some of that stuff, but the end of the first half, in my estimation, was completely inexcusable, and there's just no way you can explain that. I mean,
yeah, there is.
It's happening. We're sitting in the studio watching this, and I'm like, what are they doing? I mean, why? And I guess they score a touchdown. It's all null and void. Right. We don't even discuss it today. But when it ends the way it ended, and you lose the opportunity for an easy 3 points there, there's just no way to explain that.
Sports Radio WEEI, now on 93.7 FM in Boston.